Oh yeah. It's also worth mentioning that I knew that my car was bugged. I just didn't know there were cameras. So when I'm talking, I'm aware that there's an audience, but I didn't know who it was. I thought it was Sterling's people, that it was the government, but all my shit's bugged, man. Are you kidding me? They're just gonna let me just do whatever? That's why I get so irritated, because I'm like, no, NSA knows better. That's why I'm getting here fucking pissed off, because I'm like, no, they tune in. So anyway, I knew Sterling bugged my shit. Why wouldn't they? Right? The cameras, I didn't know. It took me a while to figure out that I didn't get this had anything to do with porn. And I didn't understand that until I figured out at Gustavo's that he wouldn't have done that unless there was like a reason. Because why would, that's not satisfying to dry hump someone to no avail, right? But there had to be a reason. And I go, huh, for some reason he wanted that to look like porn. And then I started figuring it out and I was like, oh. So let's address other things that look like, because I, look, in the beginning I was not aware that I had to be aware of what things look like instead of what they are. Okay, so let's talk about some other things that look like prostitution but aren't. There's lots of cars because I wasn't aware of things that look like. So in the beginning, you think it's easy to be homeless, and not just like normal person homeless, where you slowly digress into homelessness, like immediate, like within a week, all everything's fucked. Your car's gone, everything, you're fucked. Okay, so this is not even a normal scenario. Okay, and it's very, very hard if you've never been homeless. Well, I don't think many people have been instantaneously homeless like that. And so I didn't know how to cope. And so I thought at first that I was going to try to find someone with land. And there were two people that misled me with this. And the first was a guy in a van, right? Like the big no-no of like don't get in the car with a van. The guy with the van. But he had misled me to think that his friend had land and we were waiting on a phone call. This whole thing got really fucking weird. I was very misled. So anyway, so you guys said that I was trying to like bone the guy in the van? No. I had a fever, first of all, from sleeping in the rain for 3 days. And then when I was walking on the beach, you're like, "Need a tank, guys, keep down crack." I'm like, dude, I was so fucking hot. And I had no water. Nothing. I was like, oh, this is bad, this is bad. And you see me go to the bathroom a couple times, I'm just trying to drink out of the sink. It was bad. And it's not clean water, and it was like, oh, my God, shit, man. So it's like the beach water, basically. So anyway, this guy goes and gets his van, and that's what I thought we were waiting for, which is why if I'm a prostitute, there's no reason to grab my cat and all my shit, right? But that's what I do. I'm like, oh, okay, cool. We're waiting on this phone call to make sure it's okay with your friend. Blah blah blah. Cool. Oh, you can land. You can live there, and it's chill. Sweet. That's all I need. So I go and I grab my mirror, and because I figured that there was something, the mirror, I started to figure out in their house that there were cameras, but I didn't think anything beyond that. I don't think so. But the only reason I thought that is because Victor Carrillo online, who they tried to stage as like some Asian guy, I'm like, right, the Asian guy with the last name, because of the name Victor Carrillo, like the least Asian name ever. Okay. So anyway, and he had mentioned it's like looking into a mirror, and I'm like, there's a fucking camera here. So I was trying to take it for evidence, but there was so much going on at once, Jesus Christ. So okay, let's, God, okay. So on that one, I was like really sick. And the guy's, oh, I'm, he like came off as like, oh, I'm so spiritual, and you need a miracle. But you, I hate when people do this, and I'm like, you cannot do this to the white woman. Like, I'm like, really? Like, now I'm better at it, but I was like, okay, you cannot do this to me. So anyway, so he's like, I will get off the disease. And I'm like all for that because like I do not like being sick. I do not like it. I'm a baby now. Get off me. So he did touch my back with his shirt and everything. He's like, can you take your shirt off? I'm like, no. Can I use the oils? I'm like, no, you're making it weird. Just get the fucking disease off me, man. Like, I just don't want to be sick right now. That's all you're going to see. And that's, it wasn't sexual to me. I don't know what's going on with him. Just didn't say anything sexual. However, later on, and so he falls asleep in the chair, right? We're supposedly waiting on this phone call. And I fall asleep on the main bed, and then I wake up, and he's hella whispering weird shit in my ear, and I was like, hey, go away. Get away from me. I was like, that's freaky. Oh, he's like, I think he's like trying to hypnotize me or some shit. I swear to God, he's whispering weirder shit in my ear. And it's funny, because that's what Abe did. But it was different with her, and I was like, what the hell is this doing? I think he's trying to subliminally brainwash you. Abe will deny it, but he would sit there, and I was like, okay. I woke up. I was like, okay. He's like, I was like, I get it. Fucking stop whispering in my ear. So anyway, so then so this guy's whispering creepy shit in my ear, man. And I'm like, go away. And so anyway, and then I move across, and then again, I wake up. He's all trying to touch me. I'm like, don't touch me. So that's all you have. I'm not worried about it. So whatever you have is going to be like in the dark. Yeah, it's not, that's it. That's all that happens. Me telling this guy to go away. And then in the morning, I'm like, dude, where is the phone call? Oh, well, we might have to wait another day. And I'm like, nah, fuck yourself. You're fucking with me. I don't like this. So I leave. And then that's where I meet just one after another, dude. And that's where I meet Heather. Jesus Christ. So then Heather's going on about her... thing so fucking messy. This is why you're like, why do you avoid people? Because of this shit. That's how it was in the beginning. Shit show. So then Heather, her little kid runs up and pulls a tarot card, okay? And then she's like, makes up this whole thing, dude, about the Grateful Dead. See, he's like connecting it to my family. She's like, I'm a deadhead. I'm like, my family has one of their dogs and all this bullshit. Like, how's Angel? That's such a, such a. And then she's like, I need to get my son's safety. And she tells me this whole fucking tale about how she's running away from the Illuminati and they've had to hide in sewers and et cetera, et cetera. And so she needs to get them to the Grateful Dead so he can be safe. And I'm like, well, you know what? I'm being watched right now. So like, if you need to go, like, to do this, like, I can just, like, go with you to that. We'll just drive to the other state and then it's, like, safe entry. You know what I mean? Because he's going to watch me, so they watch you and then you're there, okay? And so, anyway, so she went on this whole thing about Panther. Her old man's name's Panther, and he's this dildo repairman at Frenchie's. For shit, you know, is what this woman's telling me. Okay, and I'm like, they have repairmen? Like, A, are you serious? Like, who wants that job? That's fucking nasty. And then she goes, she tells this guy that she needs white. I'm trying to look it up. I don't even know what that is. I thought it was heroin. Now I don't think it's heroin. Anyway, she says she needs white. I don't even think she was on drugs. I think she was fucking with that shit. And then. So she takes me driving up in the behind Highway 9 and says it makes this whole drama about finding her boyfriend with another girl, etc. Panther this, Panther that. Alright. So I'm not worried that she has foot. This is a bitch that stung me about the. You said I took a shit while smoking a peace pipe bowl. Fucking shit, man. That never happened. I just smoked a peace pipe, but I was squatting. I didn't take a shit. Fucking lie. So anyway, this lady does not have proof that I did drugs or bought drugs. I don't give a shit. I don't give a shit. You just made a bunch of bullshit. Okay. So then her friend stings me. The guy with the little like Buddha belly kinda, and it's her friend, she's getting dreads from him. Do you remember on the beach? So then she goes, go with my friend, because he has an RV, and it's going to be raining, and, like, you can live there, it's his daughter's RV, no big deal. Okay, cool. So, then, see, and then you're like, why do you avoid people? This, man. So then, I go, supposedly, his daughter's IV, and there's weed everywhere. RV, IV, great. Because I'm thinking, you're going to say it's about drug shit. There is weed everywhere, but it's not mine. And actually, if you know, there's a big spray-painted eye outside. It wasn't mine. I don't own that shit. So anyway, that guy's like, oh yeah, you can live here because my daughter this and that. Oh, he filmed me pouring water on me, right? I'm like taking a shower with water bottles. Okay, you probably filmed that, right? Well, there it is. So then, you know, put that camera. So then, he's like, oh, well, can I sleep in this bed? Because, well, I'm like, that's fine, but like, nothing funny. So we're sleeping foot to toe. And then in the morning, he's not wearing a shirt and pulls me on him. So if you have footage of me getting hugged by it, and I'm like, yeah, no. And I'm like trying to be nice about it. He also told me the Queen of England was a cannibal. I'm like, yeah, I don't believe you, but I'm gonna placate you now. So anyway, it was just shit show after shit show. Then, on top of that, I'm like, so I'm out. I'm like, I'm leaving Santa Cruz, I'm tired of this horse shit. I don't have any money, okay? I'm like, why money? And I freak out and I throw a bunch of change out on the sidewalk. I'm pissed. I'm like, what the fuck, money? What money? And I throw it out the window. And then I get my stuff and I start walking to San Francisco. I'm so mad. And I start walking up the one, like, this is gonna suck, dude. I like brought a bunch of bread rolls, it was horseshit. I walk up the one, and then this guy pulls over with an RV, and he's like, hey, so he's all bald, and he's like, do you wanna ride? But it's north. So I'm thinking, yeah, cause like, what's gonna happen? You're just gonna go north. I have to go north. Motherfucker pulls over, he's like, okay, now I'm gonna drop you off here. But then he keeps going north. I'm like, what was the point of that? The other point was to see me. I'm not worried that you have footage of anything. He's like, do you want a massage? I'm like, no, I don't. He's like, do you want to eat my food? I'm like, not really, bro. I think it's kind of creepy. He started talking about the cleanse. The cleanse. This Illuminati Nazi shit, man. I'm like, what the fuck? So anyway, when the cleanse takes place, I'm like, oh my fucking god. And then, like super Aryan and shit. I'm like, dude, you're like a skinhead or some shit. No, I don't want to be here. And then I'm walking. There's a cabbie and he's like, get in, I won't charge you. Cool, right on. So I don't get charged. He said I had money. I don't have money. So you don't see me exchanging cash. Yeah, I didn't have any money. I'm not worried. The cabbie has cameras like they typically do. He gave me a free ride. But at the end of it, he goes, oh, can I get in a hot tub with you for 20 minutes? I'm like, no. I'm getting out of your car now. Take this bottle of water. No. Why? Because it's got some fucking shit in it, man. You're all freaky. Then I'm walking. I'm like, dude, I know I'm sort of close to the airport, but not really. Good 45 minutes away, something like that, maybe longer. And this guy goes, hey, do you need a ride? And I'm like, yes. He drives me. He's like, do you want to smoke some weed? I'm like, yes. You have no idea what I've been through today. And then we smoked some weed, and then I'm like, dude, I think this shit's laced. Because he gets straight up aroused. And I'm like, yeah, no, he didn't try to pull anything, but I could just sense it, man. He was like young and everything. I'm like, no. And so I'm not worried that helter skelter. I'm like, it's a helter skelter shit. So anyway, do I have to clarify that shit? I'll clarify that shit. So then, he goes. He gives me a ride, and you probably made up some more shit, which you can't prove. Cool, whatever. Fact is, I fall asleep at the airport, and then they check my shit, right? So I don't have drugs or money, or they would have found it. Oh, and there was like five cops, too, and it was just a scarf. You gotta find it. And then, they get kicked out of the airport, and go to Drew's, and I get thrown in the loony bin, and you wonder how I end up at Gustavo's. Because look at everything I just went through just to get up to the Bay fucking area, because you jacked my car keys. Are you happy with yourself?
You take rides from people and you talk to people
because of this horse shit, man. That's all that makes me look like a prostitute. I'm over it.